Hello everyone, today we will review Creality's new resin printer, the Halot Mage S. Halot is one of Creality's most important series because until this series started, Creality was more known for its FDM printers. It was not much preferred on the resin side, however, with Halot One, Halot One Pro, and especially the Halot Sky, which holds a special place for me, it quickly found its place in the resin printer market. With Halot Mage, the aim was to produce resin printers that could offer performance without raising the price bar too high. First, let's briefly look at the design and features, then I will share both my user experiences and the printings I have obtained. The Halot Mage S has exactly the same design as the Mage and Mage Pro models. It features a dark gray metal main body at the bottom and an orange UV protective cover at the top. The 4.3-inch color touchscreen on the front has good touch sensitivity and a relatively fast response time. The interface is simple. Additionally, the printer supports many languages. When we remove the protective cover, we see the large resin tank. In the resin tank, there is a film called Pictor by Creality for high-speed printing. This film resembles ACF film with its flexible structure and hazy appearance. Under this tank, there is a mono LCD screen with a very high resolution of 14K. Thanks to this screen, Mage S provides a precision of 16.8 by 24.8 microns on the XY axis. The printing plate is made of aluminum and has been laser etched on the printing surface. This not only creates a beautiful appearance, but also makes it easier for the resin to adhere to the plate. The maximum printing dimensions we can achieve on the plate are 22.3 cm in width, 12.6 cm in depth, and the maximum printing height is 23 cm. The plate movement occurs on a dual linear rail with a single low vibration high torque motor. Thanks to this system, there is less oscillation on the Z-axis, which also helps create smoother surfaces in our printings. On the right inner side, we see the carbon filter system. The fan here filters the resin odor through carbon filters, and if desired, expels the filtered air outside with the help of an exhaust. Creality has also included an extension tube in the box that we can connect to this air outlet. Thus, you can directly output from a place close to the window. Halot Mage S has wireless connectivity. You can connect your printer to the network and control it remotely. You can send the models we sliced with Halot Box to your printer. Additionally, by optionally purchasing Creality's smart camera, the Nebula, you can observe the printing in real time or record time-lapse videos. Another optional apparatus is the resin filling pump. If you wish, you can also integrate this into the printer and perform resin filling and emptying operations with this apparatus. Halot Mage S is a fast MSLA printer and allows you to achieve printing up to 15 cm in height per hour with a layer quality of 0.2 mm using Creality Fast Resin designed for speed. The features look nice. Printer screens have now reached 14K, progressing from 2, 4, 6, and 8. There are some features I like about this printer, but there are also parts that make me think it would be better if they were included. I will share all of these with you. Let's take a look at the sample printings I received. The first printing I got is a fantastic figure. It has a lot of detail on it. I must say it was a very difficult printing. Printing models with such fine details is always challenging. For example, the teeth, the tiny skulls on it, and the most challenging part, the chain in the right hand and its continuation. Because the places where you can add support at this point are very limited. The model needs to rise on sharp and very small points, which makes the likelihood of successful printing quite difficult. I was able to print beautifully and achieve a perfect result at every point of the model. The ground underneath was printed with an FDM printer. In such resin printings, if there are parts that are not detailed, especially like the base, I like to use FDM printers in combination with SLA printers. It's the same in both models I will show you shortly. This is a warrior. Overall, it's a very beautiful printing, but I found errors in two points. One of these is due to STL Flix, from which I downloaded the model. For resin printers, there are also models with preset supports to make things easier for users. They forgot to add support at this point. The tip of the spear consists of two pieces like a fork. There is a crack there, but since I forgot to put support, that part lifted from the edge. I reported this to STL Flix and they said they would fix it. So, when you download it, this error will probably not be there. Another point that caught my eye is a printing error. At a certain point on the clothing, a few layers look very shiny. This layer mark has continued in the same way down to the leg. However, to be honest, I don't know what caused this error. It's not a big problem. If this figure is painted, it won't be noticeable. Aside from these, every point looks quite good. There are fine patterns on the weapon and the helmet. It came out quite clear. I can indeed see the facial details through the helmet. The detail I liked the most on the model was the warrior's shield. It was a very clear and successful printing. The Pegasus detail on it is also quite beautiful. Of course, printing such figures with resin printers is quite enjoyable. They are also good for test reviews in videos because, as you can see, there are a lot of details that can be evaluated. I also generally recommend SLA-type printers to those who say they want to print figures for themselves. Of course, without ignoring its difficulties, because we are working with chemicals using an SLA printer. Resin is a toxic material and it is harmful if it comes into contact with the skin. During the cleaning process, we use isopropyl alcohol, which is also a chemical. Therefore, to prevent skin contact, we should wear protective gloves. To avoid being affected by the smell of resin and isopropyl alcohol and to prevent volatile organic compounds from harming our bodies, we should at least use an N95 mask. In fact, it would be even better if a half-face gas mask is used instead of an N95s, and ensuring that the environment is well ventilated is absolutely essential. To reduce contact with chemicals, I recommend using washing and curing machines. Much more efficient and easier than hand washing or sun curing. This is Creality's latest UW03 washing and curing machine. It simplifies my post-printing tasks. I will also address the pros and cons again at the end of the video. There is one more figure, but it holds a special place for me. Before that, let's take a look at these printings I have prepared. Here I made some casting molds to be used for wax casting and plastic injection. Since the outer surface quality is not important in these models, I used thick supports to keep the model sturdy. Therefore, the support marks are noticeable on the outer surface. What really matters are the inner parts. There are no traces here. It's a very nice printing. What you see here is a gear mold modeled for plastic injection. A nice printing, but I see a thin line in one of the layers of the models. Other than that, I did not encounter any problems. I made these printings not so much to show the printing quality, but to give an idea. So you can use resin printers when you need molds for wax, soap casting, or plastic injection molding. And now we come to the final printing. I'm sure you already recognized who it is just from his stance, Yusuf Dikec, who won a silver medal in the 10-meter air pistol shooting category at the 2024 Paris Olympics. This was a team game, and Yusuf Dikec competed alongside Cheval Ilayda Tarhan. So, in fact, this success belongs to both of them. But of course, Yusuf Dikec's relaxed stance with his hand in his pocket without using any extra equipment other than his pistol made headlines worldwide and naturally stood out. He's been called the Turkish Hitman and the Turkish James Bond. Hitman even shared this on his official X account. Especially in the Far East, anime and manga drawings were made. This model you see also belongs to Bahadur Uysal, an artist I have great respect for and have been following for a long time. It's a great 3D model. As soon as I saw it, I downloaded it and did the printing. Let's take a look at the printing quality in the model. You can download this model if you want. Initially, there are not many details on the model, so it doesn't have as many as those fantastic figures at the beginning. You might think the printing was easy, but it wasn't. The model was printed as a single piece. Here it was important to properly set the supports because the glasses, the trigger of the gun, or the arm were suspended in the air. Fortunately, I didn't encounter any issues while removing the supports except for breaking a tiny part of the gun. The contours of his face, down to the fine lines on his forehead and between his eyebrows, came out beautifully detailed, resulting in a flawless printing. You might have noticed layer marks on the upper parts. The reason is, I am printing the model at a layer quality of 100 microns. If you don't want to see these marks or want them to be less noticeable, you can increase the quality to 50 microns, or 0.05 millimeters, with the Halot Mage S. Creality Halot Mage S is definitely a beautiful resin printer. It is compact, easy to use, and made from high-quality materials. The slicing software works much better than it did a few years ago. There is no significant difference in the UW03 washing and curing machine compared to previous models. The best improvement is that the turntable is rectangular. This allows for more efficient use of space, and the basket coming out of the washing chamber can be placed directly here. However, I would like to see an increase in the number of ultraviolet lights, at least coming from one more angle, and a system where we can gradually wash the printing plate. The film used in the resin tank, which Creality calls Pictor, is nice. It does not show any resistance to printing. It is a recommended film for fast printing. However, the box also contains one standard FEP film. You can use this FEP film for printing at standard speed. These films are not things that can be easily swapped in and out. Therefore, my advice to you is to use your existing film until it wears out. I mentioned that the Pictor film is similar to the ACF film. Sometimes layer lines appear on ACF films. Sometimes small dots would appear on the upper parts of the model. This also happened with the film called Pictor, so in my opinion, there's no need for fancy names. This is an ACF film. I am starting to be surprised that Creality has been using the same bed leveling system since their first resin printer, because their competitors are advancing quickly. Now, features like automatic bed leveling and pressure sensors have started to appear in SLA printers in this price segment. I don't know how well the new features in this segment work, but I think Creality should also integrate them into their printers. The air filter works well. It is possible to vent the air outside the usage area with the hose that comes with it. Creality has not yet released an air purifier device, but perhaps in the future it will be possible to use the printer more healthily by connecting it to such a device. I wish the camera was integrated, but Creality's Nebula camera is a good device, and since it is compatible with other newly released Creality printers, having it as an optional feature might be advantageous for some users. A surprise for me in the box was the one-year Chitubox Pro license. Halotbox software is nice, but Chitubox is a much more professional software with detailed settings that resin printer users frequently prefer. Therefore, this gift was nice. Overall, I also liked the printing quality. Apart from a few lines and dots that I suspect are due to the ACF film, there were no printing errors. I think if you are looking for a relatively large MSLA printer, you can choose the Creality Halot Mage S. If you also want to get one, I have added the product link in the description of the video. Yes, that's all I have to say about the Creality Halot Mages. I hope this was an enjoyable video. How did you find this video and printer? I look forward to your comments. May your printer work smoothly and your printings be flawless. See you in the next video. Goodbye.